Good afternoon, everyone. So today we are starting the unit 2, your combustion process. Today we are discuss the last section of your unit 1. Before the lunch, we are discuss about the last section of unit 1, calculation part of power and how to produce the power as per the maximum demand for the consumer. We are already discussed. Now we are discussing about your combustion process. So first of all, what is combustion process? Before we are going to do or solving the problems of combustion process, first we will discuss about the properties of combustion process. Then after that, we will proceed to go the solving problem section. Okay. So first of all, we have to know what is combustion. What is combustion? In that automobile sector, combustion process will take in that combustion chamber after while passing the air fuel mixture in the section, then it will goes to the combustion process. In that IC engine, there are two types: spark ignition system or combustion ignition system. In that spark ignition, in that combustion chamber, we are just ignited the spark and the air fuel mixture will burn. In that diesel engine, we are giving the some small droplets of fuel with that air fuel injector. Fuel injector, we are passing that the fuel in that combustion chamber. Then the combustion process will take, the burning gas will be goes to the downside, and after that the expansion stoke will be stoke will be there. Then after that the final stoke, exhaust will be stoke will be there. That exhaust stoke, the exhaust valve will be open, inlet valve will be closed. Whatever the burning air fuel mixture will be there in that cylinder, that it goes out from the cylinder, and then that the air fuel burning air fuel mixture through the silencer will goes out to the atmosphere. You know already these things. The main procedure, or we can say that the main part of the cylinder is their combustion. If the combustion will take as per the norms of our cylinder, or as per the criteria of the air fuel mixture, it gives the power. If it is the combustion process will take at the limit section of the ratio of the compression, it give the good power to generate, and that power will be transmission through the an automobile crankshaft to the dry shaft, and then dry shaft will move in that automobile sector. The dry shaft will give the power transmission to the wheel, and then wheel will be moved. Then only the car will, or trucks, or whatever the automobile sector is automobile sector, car, motorcycle, we can say that the trucks, then only it will move from one place to another place. Okay, so other things will be there. We don't go to other thing. We need not go for other thing. Just we are remembering and revising what is the combustion process will be take in that automobile. You are already learn about this automobile subject in the last semester. Before the last semester, you are already learn about the automobile. All the things we need not to go again for the section of automobile. Here we are considering just what is combustion process. Just we are discusses about the combustion process. Now we are going in the main combustion process. Just general example of general basic definition of combustion we are considering here. Here the lecture note for your unit 2. So I will proceed the combustion process. Here the combustion process. What is the combustion process? Just now we are discussed. Combustion process is also as a burning process, we can say that the burning process. Here the air fuel mixture we are inserting in that cylinder, and then the suction will goes to complete that the combustion will be taken. In that air fuel mixture we are using the chemical like fuel, in that fuel petrol, diesel, hydraulic, machineries are using the sources are hydraulic fuels also. The process of releasing energy from the fuel air fuel mixture, internal combustion engine, IC engine. In that IC engine we are producing the combustion stoke in that compression. Then compression will take and the combustion stoke. At that combustion stoke the heat will be produced, and that heat goes to the after the combustion process to the expansion sector. Then expansion exhaust will be there. So at the heat level, fossil fuel power plant operation produce the combustion process. Then through the combustion process heat is goes to the modern power plant. Then modern power plant, to know about the combustion process we are taking the example of automobile, but here the after the completion of combustion process the heat will goes to the power plant, and that power plant burning of heat of fuel is release the energy, and then energy goes to the generator. In that generator energy of the heat in terms of steam, and then it is utilized to converting and transforming to the electricity. Here the main concept of combustion process is there. In that combustion process, whatever the air fuel mixture is inserting in that IC engine, it will be totally burned, and that burn gas or burn air fuel mixture is goes to the power plant, modern power plant, and then it gives and it's release the energy, and that energy goes to the steam, goes to the generator in terms of steam, and it is energy will transformed into the electricity. That electricity is storing in that source section, and then it will goes to the consumer place. Okay, this is the combustion process. Properties of coal. Properties, here we have to know the properties of coal, because of which property of coal we are taking to air fuel mixture entering to the combustion. As per the generating of power, we should know about this criteria level of properties. Carbon, here the chemical properties, various chemical properties are there to generate the power. Here we are using the chemical properties of coal is carbon. The elements of carbon express here the dry minerals matter free. Here we are using the carbon's dry minerals matter free. Between the three bases should be variant 85 to 88%. Here the percentage of the carbon of the capacity, pure capacity, is we are using 85 to 88%. If we are considering the hydrogen base should be vary between 3.7 to 4.5%. The DMMF, what is DMM? Dry mineral matter free. Dry mineral matter free is everyone having dry mineral matter free capacity of chemical property E is there. So for hydrogen 3.75 to 4.5%, sulfur is 0.575, should be not exceed the property of the sulfur base is should be not exceed the 0.75. Phosphorus, the phosphorus capacity in that between the base is 0.15 to 0.25, and should be not exceed by the 0.25. Other elements such as nitrogen, iron and rare element must be present in trace. other elements as per the requirement we are taking other element. That other elements like nitrogen and iron is are rarely used in that chemical properties of the coal. Combustion fuel, different types of combustion fuels are there with that symbol or molecular weight, atom symbol or molecular weights, molecules and atoms. We are considering here the molecules and atoms. Different types of combustion fuels are taking to in that combustion chamber. These are the different types of combustion fuels. These are the fuels we are taking inside the combustion chamber, like hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, carbon, sulfur and water, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide. Marsh gas is nothing but methane, ethylene and ethane. These are the different fuels are there we are considering in that combustion chamber for the requirement purpose, other as per our requirement or as per our generating of power, and different types of fuel we are using. Here the symbols are there, here the molecular weights are there, and here also atom name is there, here the molecular weight is there. Okay, why here the dash is represented means this is the combination of two elements. That's why the combination of two elements, there is no such a accurate symbol, accurate symbol is there. Combination of two elements of producing any chemical, that is no saturate symbol or molecular weight of the atom is there. Okay, carbon. After that we are discussing in deep the chemical properties of the each and every one. Carbon, if the complete combustion, if we are using the carbon fuel in that combustion chamber, the two things will be happened. If it is complete combustion or it is incomplete combustion, these are the things we will discuss in the next class. Today just I am stopping here for combustion of fuels. So these are the different types of combustion fuels or molecular weights or symbols. You have to remember these all things, then only you can go to the further procedure to make sure to reaction or completion of the conversation of the units also, then only you can get that easy values if you know this table. So make sure to learn or understand about this symbols or molecular weights. Okay, so thank you very much for listening my video. Comment on your attendance in that in the last class I already given to the link of Google form. Like that the Google form link will be there here also, so you have to just click that link and put your attendance in that link. As per the whatever the details should there, you have to just put the details and submit it your attendance. Okay, thank you very much, and next class we will discuss about this remaining parts of the your second unit. Okay.